All right, we were supposed to do that. All right.
Yeah, but
back to it. Fuck it. Let's go with what we have.
I mean, I have other stuff, but I think the one that we have equipped right now is our best skill set. And you can press square. Pick punchy. Unless you want to play.
Oh, right, else. Right. I forgot about that.
We can choose Neo or Evil Yamcha as a character to be on our side. Like, go down. He's right directly below Yamcha.
Oh, okay. Super villain.
I said do it. Go over, because there was one other character I saw that was Neo. Just be careful about it. Oh, hold on. Go back. No, there. I saw the Great Saiyan Man, but go back over to the left. Maybe not. Go back over the right. Maybe it was Broly. Or no. Oh, it's Gogeta.
Where?
In the middle, right next to Whis.
Huh.
Yeah.
Dead Gogeta.
Alright, I don't care who you choose, but...
Oh, I'll take it from Bardock.
Yeah, that's cool.
This will make for a perfect warm-up.
I like how they gave him the Timebreaker Bardock outfit, too.
Yeah.
And granted, it makes sense because he's the model's in the game, but, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, right. So I don't remember why I chose any of these skills, but, yeah.
To the side! I'll finish this! Well, that's not true. There's nothing in my database about you at all. Either way, if you try to stop this, you'll tear down the phone. Come on. You can't do this all before. You can't rush me.
What about you, 16? You got any data on this different?
Damn it!
No relevant matches.
Bitch!
Patched out.
What?
He got it. Patch out how good Super Kamehameha was, because the other guy surprised me. He needs to talk. Hey, there's 16.
Don't think I'll lose that easily.
Oh, I remember why I did this one. Because we have to assist Cell.
That presents a bit of a conundrum for me, because defeating both of them on my current stage. So good luck.
I don't know how many there are. There are actually other stuff that I would like to do.
Me lose to a dated bucket of bolts?
I'm gonna go grab Broly skills. Use discretion.
How do I?
You have to fully charge it. To
oh.
System failure imminent.
Is it not doing it?
Maybe
I just should have been able to do it from there. Upgrade to Super Saiyan. I suppose there was only one of those. So. There you go.
And it was
and for the kill.
Oh.
So finally show us. Don't worry, you'll reach perfection, all right. You'll be perfectly cold and lifeless when I'm done. What is that? Where's that power coming from?
I think it's because of the fight.
I think this might have something to do with like the original like timeline. And the first form cell just absorbing everybody before Piccolo even fights him. But for some reason I wanna do this quest.
Took too much damage.
I mean, granted, he blocked like a whole bunch of it. The only thing I saw, though... No, this is a different penalty. I did try out the Kaioken. But it actually turns off your Super Saiyan sometimes.
Yeah.
Oh, this feels right. Both mentor and student. Perfect in every way.
Why, thank you.
That's what I like, Cell.
We got 18's clothes and energy field.
Oh, that's gonna be so useful.
Yeah, considering they still don't allow you to cross-dress in this game. Which doesn't even make sense, because some clothes are, like, from male people, and you could put them on females, like King Kai's clothes. You can totally put that on a female character. Now, I did want to go see Broly.
Greetings.
Broly is Broly. In the Broly. Mushroom District. Brack. Right. I also wanted to fight Barack Obama. Barack Obama.
So you're the one that's been hurting my beloved followers. I'm the leader of the Nuts Gang, and now you've made me mad. It's time for payback.
So I did this kind of off-screen, but I was like, oh my god, I have to fight Obama. The last thing Obama does in office is fight Punchie!
Is it racist that he's also gray?
With no?
What? No, with black, he has black face and black lips.
Oh my god, now that I think about it, you're right. He has so much health!
And he's so
weak. Yeah, it does go like that. Oh my god. It's time for a fist, holy. It does so much damage. And he's still stamina broken, so just now he was able to get out of that. Yeah. Holy shit! All of my stamina, all of it was just gone. Get up, Punchy. Get out of there. Get out of there. Gotta eat of the tree of might. No, maybe not. Get out of here! Time for a fist! Stop it!
I defeated
the 44th president of the United States. I got so much experience from that. I almost leveled up twice, Jesus.
It seems like I've had an advantage over you, Mr. President.
Okay, so I just want to point this out. I'm just going to float this by you. I just thought of this. But we did say that in our theory, only Goku and Vegeta's families are able to go Super Saiyan, right?
Yeah.
Technically, that involves Yanni Boy.
Yeah, because so, he's brothers with
Punchie. And technically, that also includes one other character.
Who?
Superman. So we could potentially have Super Saiyan...
Super Saiyan Man.
That being said, I don't think we'll ever find a game that we want to play where we play as somebody that we can call Superman, but... I just want to float that by everybody. Where is Broly? Oh, there you are. Die! I'm really glad that Vic Mignogna is able to get so much money from this his role as Broly, even though he just has to grunt and scream
most of the time.
Yeah, because Broly's so popular that he's in like every fucking Dragon Ball game, but he doesn't talk very much at all. Like I guarantee he talks more in this game than he does in any other like medium.
Take an 83 game.
Oh yeah, bro, Blaster Cell is still really good, it looks like. That being said, it's still a good game. Yeah, Blaster Cell was something I used all the time in the first game, so I'm gonna equip that and replace it for the
So you're more than a worm.
That's all I wanted from Bully.
Interesting. I've decided to let you live. That way I can make you.
So you've seen the first Brilliant movie, right? Does he seem like the kind of person that would just enjoy
when he was in the
suffering?
First two forms, he was like he was very
Oh no, that's right. He lacks key control, so as he goes into the legendary Super Saiyan form, he like is a kind of enveloped by it and goes mad by it, by ki. So that does kind of make more sense now that I think about it. But I think that, like, base form Broly would not be the kind of person to be like,
I just met you,
I'm just gonna make you suffer, I'm gonna keep you around.
He was, like, pretty normal, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was only after he...
Find Kakarot! He's right over that mountain. Jeez, whatever.
Selling out your own son, you son of a bitch.
No, I don't want... I only tell him because I know he's never gonna do anything about it.
What?
Broly. He's like, I want him to fight Kakarot. He's over there. I want to fight him tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm sure he will.
I don't think that's... what time is it? 1:40? Nah, let's go do some expert quests real quick. Just to try it out. Because... we can do the parallel quest later, but the DLC comes out December 20th, and we're gonna come back with the game then. And we gotta show off the skills, of course. So that gives us something to do, but expert quests is a little different. So what we wanna do to actually progress, this is what I think is really dumb, is that if you play online with these, you don't actually count, it doesn't count as finishing the quest unless you are the host. And so, there's no point for anybody to ever help anybody else on these expert quests. So, yeah, I think it's super dumb. So, yeah, we're just gonna wait here. Let me see if I have anything else to talk about. And we never finished talking about Lilo and Stitch. Yeah, but... I thought the, the trailers for it were really good. But... you can imagine my distaste when I saw the movie and it has nothing to do with the actual plot. So, throughout the years, Lilo and Stitch, as good of a movie as it is, it has always kind of left a sour taste in my mouth.
I never got the point of the second movie.
The second movie was definitely different.
What about that third one?
I don't even remember, because they made so many Lilo and Stitch sequels.
No, they're all...
speaking of sequels, like...
three.
What?
I think there were only three.
Well, they also had a TV show.
Third was, like, the opening to the TV show.
Yeah. No, I think that was the second one. The third one was, like, the worst one. Stitch has a glitch.
No, that was two.
No, that was the third one.
No, that was two. I swear
it came. It came later. Because they had the second movie as an intro for the TV show. The TV show happened, and then, like, 3 years after the TV show ended, they made the third movie. Dude, we can look this up. In fact, that's what I'm going to do now. Okay, Google. Lilo and Stitch movies.
I might actually just watch the first one when I get home tonight.
It's on Netflix.
Yeah, that's the whole thing.
Oh, speaking of which, you know what I found was on Netflix that was really fun to like go through? The original, or not the original, but the 1995 Goosebumps series.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, like, me and Kristen found it. We were like, this is going to be super cheesy and dumb.
Yeah.
And we watched it through the first episode, and we're like, this is actually kind of a really funny, but enjoyable time. And so, to anybody watching this, and Pilot, I guess he's here, I do recommend going and, like, if you have Netflix, just watching the Goosebumps series, because it's a good time. Like, if you enjoy, like, cheesy 1990s or 1980s TV shows, like, definitely it's for you, because there's so many, like, it's entertaining, because it's Goosebumps, right? But there's also so much of it that's like, oh, man. Why isn't this loading? Can't reach Google at the moment. Perfect. Lilo and Stitch movies! Hello, GeoCeo. Thanks in advance. Advance. Game Boy Advance.
Too bad there isn't. I made a YouTube channel. You should watch it. Is recipient.
Fine. Well, fuck it. We're just doing this, dude. Like I said, nobody ever wants to help with anybody else, so it's just what we're gonna have to do. Now, I'm just gonna be punchy. I forget who we're fighting here. I think it was Great Aunt Nappa or something. Do you have internet? Can you look up the Lilo and Stitch question?
Okay.
Because I'm not getting internet on my phone for some reason.
I think because you need to connect to the Wi-Fi.
Maybe.
Yeah, it's absolute shit down here. The internet.
Well, no, I just mean that it's connected, but it's not registering anything. Like, that's just kind of what happens. All right, Nappa, time to get destroyed. Evil explosion in your face.
Pop up absolutely just pissed me off.
What the fuck? Oh, hold on a second. Got those numbers for us, pilot?
This next attack is catch it. Send it right back where it came from.
Oh wait. Oh shit.
Yeah, so something weird popped up on it.
Wow, that's cool. I gotta get out of here. Someone push it back. Oh, thank goodness.
All right. So, first of all, it was Lilo and Stitch in 2002.
Okay.
And then in 2005, they released a mini movie called The Origin of Stitch.
Yes.
Then 2003 to 2006, it was the series.
Okay.
And then,
I'm guessing the second movie technically was part of the series then, because I remember that Origins of Stitch movie, that's not the same thing.
Hang on a second, it's the sun. Okay, here we go.
Okay.
So, yes, 2002 it was Lilo and Stitch.
Yes.
2003 it was Stitch the movie.
Okay.
2005 is Lilo and Stitch 2. Stitch has a glitch.
Wait, what was that last one?
It's called Stitch the movie.
No. The date for Stitch has a glitch.
2005.
That's weird. That came out during the time that Stitch was going.
2006. It was Leroy and Stitch. Then...
That's right! That happened, too! But I could have sworn Stitch Has a Glitch came out way after that.
And Lilo and the show was from 2003 to 2006.
Well done!
Yeah,
life
I
entertaining! Keep up the good work!
Dude. We got Murder Grenade. That sounds metal as hell. I'm actually gonna see what that is.
Jesus, how many other people were there?
It was just the one person, but it fills in the other slots as AI characters.
Oh.
So just having one person there actually managed to do it.
Hey, everybody!
Oh, God!
Fuck off, Krillin!
No, we have to do it.
Why?
Because it's just... super RNG when it activates and shit.
RNG?
Random generator. It's totally random when these pop up and you have to do them 10 times to get the fucking trophy.
How many times have you done it?
I don't know.
Five!
I don't think that's accurate because certain times...
No, target. It's five people.
It's five people, yes. Why are you behind this building, bro?
Hey there!
Sis? God, they're so spread out. Okay. Do you have anything to talk about?
I don't know. What was next on that list?
I didn't have anything left.
You ran out of stuff already?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, you were not prepared for this.
Actually, there was something I did want to talk about, and I've been wanting to talk about it for a while. Is that when X-Men Apocalypse came out and Civil War came out, people were like, why isn't Deadpool in Apocalypse? And why isn't Hulk in Civil War? And I'm like, you all are fucking dumbasses. Deadpool took place in the 2010s. Apocalypse came to take place in the 80s. At best, Deadpool's a baby, so there's that.
Deadpool baby.
Deadpool baby. Hulk's not in Civil War because he fucking left after...
He's in hiding.
...in Age of Ultron, so I don't understand how people fucking forgot, I don't know.
It was kind of mentioned in the movie.
Yeah, it was even mentioned! Well, not really. Like, they ask where Hulk was, but I don't think they ever say, where...
They were still looking.
Granted,
all that they need to say.
Granted, yeah, but like, granted, this all is a way to not pay all the actors for being in the movie, of course. Like, even cameos, you gotta pay them kind of a lot. But freaking Mark Ruffalo, oh my god.
Oh, that's so offensive.
That is bad.
I'm not gonna
say it out loud.
We're
although,
definitely
no,
not.
Actually, I do have something related to that, because remember, sudden...
I don't know. Just, what were you about to say?
Sun and Moon are based off of Hawaii,
yeah.
Region, right? And before it came out, I kept on making jokes that the area that Pearl Harbor, that the memorial place was, that I thought that they were going to make, like, something Japanese-esque for that whole area. They totally did that. I'm not even fucking kidding.
Was it that?
Mali City. It's, like, a tribute to Eastern culture, right? And then I thought about it, and I was like, this is totally where Pearl Harbor happened. Holy fuck.
Oh my god.
I could be wrong. Someone's gonna correct me in the comments, probably, but...
Hopefully somebody does.
Granted, the fact that they have, like, Japanese-esque stuff there on a Hawaiian-based region is just kind of insulting, I'm thinking.
You know, like, this music playing in the background making this so much more dramatic than it should be.
Yeah, I switched it to music number 5, because...
Yeah, the ones are awful.
Other ones are kind of awful, except for the end theme, I guess. But, yeah, this does kind of help for the milk delivering being super urgent and stuff. So I just have to never press X. That's the deal. Oh my god, there's still 2 more after this, asshole. You want to talk about Sun and Moon a little bit?
Yeah, we haven't really
had a chance to for the channel.
Hey!
Yeah.
Because I already mentioned earlier that we're going to do stars for the channel, and I think that's the only thing coming up that we're really looking forward to. Because Breath of the Wild got another fucking, like,
delay?
Got pushed back, yeah, delay. Got another fucking delay, so it's not even coming out in March anymore. There have been rumors of a June release.
Wait, hold on. When is the episode going to be released?
Late December.
Oh, okay, cool. So we can tell them about what's going on in Toonami.
Yeah, Toonami's getting super dub.
Hi there.
Dragon Ball super dub.
Hey, I got put in.
Okay, so, anyway, yeah. So, how did you enjoy the game, Mr. Quaza? Pokemon
Sun and Moon? I thought, like, for the first 3 quarters of it was really good. Like, I enjoyed a lot of the new innovations for it. However, there are some stuff where it just totally drops the ball. And I think a lot of it does come from the fact that it's maxing out, like, what the potential of a 3DS game is. The game runs super slow. Like, there's lag between, like, this is offline, of course, too. Like, just the main story. The game lags between, like, turns and stuff, and the health bars drain so slow. Like, if you try and hit something, if you try to knock something out at, like, 1 HP, there's a moment where it just doesn't move, and you're like, did that not kill it?
As a person who uses an old 3DS, I'd actually second that.
Yeah. Oh, and that's the thing.
It gets really laggy when you do 4-on-4.
I played the whole game as on a new 3DS. Apparently, on the old 3DSs, which a lot of people still own because the new 3DSs have no benefit to them, except you can play Xenoblade Chronicles 3D on it.
I want to play that game so badly.
But you can, yeah, you can find the... Now you can actually find the Wii version. Pretty available. But yeah. If you play it on an old 3DS, the game chugs like hell when there's anything more than two Pokemon on screen, just because of everything it's trying to process at one time. But yeah, not only that, but I think like some of the design choices were really lame. Like, the SOS battle system is really bad. I think that regular wild Pokemon should not be able to call for help unless you exclusively use the Adrenaline Orb item.
I fucking hate this.
But it's like, yeah, if you're just trying to knock out this stupid fucking Pidgey or whatever, it shouldn't be able to fucking call more every single time because you just barely can't one-kill these.
No.
It just, you can get stuck infinitely in these battles. There's no limit to how many you'll find.
So,
like, granted, the SOS battles have benefits of you can EV train a lot easier than Horde or Super training was in X and Y, and shiny hunting is easier than ever, but still, like, just... just frustrates me to no end.
Some of the capture rates for these Pokemon, I think they've gotten changed.
Yeah, no, I don't
especially
know.
Especially for Butterfree. Like, it's supposed to be one of the easiest ones to catch, right?
No, not really.
Oh, really?
Butterfree's a fully evolved Pokemon. I don't think you've been able to catch it in the wild before.
I did. It took me, like, 4 or 5 Ultra Balls.
In Diamond?
No. Moon. Yeah, Moon.
No, before Moon. You're
No, I've never caught a Butterfree.
Okay, every Pokemon has set catch rates for their species. Caterpie has a significantly lower catch rate than Butterfree. So if you were to find a Butterfree in the wild, it's going to be harder to catch than a Caterpie.
That explains how I drained like 3 or 4 Ultra Balls on that thing.
Yeah.
You know, there was this photo I found with this guy who actually was talking to a kid in the schools, and he said something that's very true. I wonder whose job it is to pick all the Pokeballs that don't get to capture a Pokemon in them. Just like you know how I told you about how I tried fighting the one of the island spirits, like Tapu Bulu?
Yeah.
And it took me like 16 or 17 Ultra Balls.
Oh man, I'm just glad that they don't have SOS battles attached to them.
Oh, thank God they didn't have SOS.
I think the fucking Ultra Beasts are the fucking worst. Like, I hate their designs. I think they honestly add, like,
they just added a whole new level of bullshit.
They're just kind of bullshit, and I don't like them. Like, I've never been the kind of person that's
sick,
like...
Sick drift, bro.
I've never been the kind of person that's been like, I don't like these new Pokemon designs, I hate this generation. Like, there's like one or two Pokemon per generation that I'm just like, nah, this one, it could have been better. Like, a lot of the fairy-type Pokemon that were introduced in X and Y, I think Beware, it looks really dumb.
I hate
this generation. However, the Ultra Beasts, all of them, to me, they just kind of fucking suck. And there's just... And, you know, I was... What's most disappointing is the fact that I actually saw one that I kind of liked, and I looked it up, and it's not actually an Ultra Beast at all. It's just another legendary Pokemon. Wow, okay. That just kind of cements my opinion about Ultra Beasts, then.
You think if they do another
also,
game, they're gonna actually ferment, like, add more Ultra Beasts?
Oh my god, I hope not. I hope this is kind of like just a Sun and Moon thing. But that being said, they still have Stars to come out, so... Yeah.
I'm sure it's gonna be the exact same, just for... it's just gonna have both legendaries.
I've never hoped for this before, but I hope it is. I hope they don't actually expand on Ultra Beasts and shit, because that would suck.
I expect stars to have both legendaries.
Like I said, I really enjoyed the game. I liked the story and all, but I think the fourth quarter of the game really fucking dropped the ball. And it's really disappointing because this game was really good to start off with, and just having the spike of going from the third island to the fourth island, everything's levels go up by 10 levels just to try and up the difficulty. The game's super short, and there's, like, nothing to do post-game again, because one games have not had a good post-game since we're Platinum. Oh no, I'll say Heart Gold Silver, because they technically came out after Platinum, but yeah, they haven't had a good post-game story stuff since 4th generation. I think that really just
sucks.
Like, granted,
because that's the problem I have with games is post-game stuff.
Post-game stuff, yeah. I think Pokemon has one of the most potentials to do it, because you end the game with your Pokemon just above level 50. Pokemon go up to level 100. I think that has plenty of potential. And they've never really explored that. Like, X and Y was probably the best. Like, they packed a whole lot of game into that. And your Pokemon, by the end of that, are in their 70s. So, honestly, yeah. Okay, so we've just kind of been rambling about nothing, and nothing's actually been happening. So I'm just going to end the video here. Thank you for joining us for
Side by Side
podcast. I'm Shikuquaza.
I'm ZGPilot.
Join us next time as we explore the DLC, because we're not fucking coming back to this game until it comes out.
Late December.
Sorry, Xenoverse 2 sucks.